This is an unusual question about an elastic collision. So I have two carts, and one of them has a spring on it, and that's going to make it so the carts bounce off of each other, and they each will have their own final velocity. And I solved that sort of ordinary problem in another video already, and I'll just post a link to that. But in this problem, we want to know, what's the maximum compression of that spring while the collision is actually occurring? And this is, for the most part, just a concept question, because once you figure it out, there's hardly any math to do. So we have to imagine what's happening when the collision begins. The 2 kilogram cart will be moving faster than the 1.5 and squishing the spring as a result. And then at some point, the 1.5 kilogram mass starts to bounce off, which means it's now moving faster than the 2 kilogram mass. So what's right in between those two? The 2 kilogram approaching the 1.5 and then the 1.5 running away from the 2 kilogram. There's a special moment where they're actually moving at exactly the same speed. And that allows me to very quickly solve this using momentum conservation. So at this special moment, they're sharing the same speed. The distance between them is switching between getting smaller and getting bigger. So right at this moment, the distance between them is not changing at all and they have the same speed. And when I apply momentum conservation to this, it's as simple as an inelastic collision. I would just say P initial equals P final. And my initial momentum was 2 kilograms times 3 meters per second. And my final momentum is 3.5 kilograms, all moving at the same speed, a V final, and I've got V final immediately. And I get 1.714 meters per second. Well, how is this going to get us where we need to go? The key here is that I know that the total energy in the initial state is going to be equal to the energy in the final state, because it's a perfectly elastic collision. I'm using a spring to do that. So what I'm going to do is find out, if I just look at how fast these masses are going in the final state, how much energy is missing? And then I'm going to say that the missing energy is, at this moment, stored in the spring, and then I should be able to find the compression. So my initial kinetic energy for the system, it's 1/2 times the mass times the speed squared. And I get 9 joules out of that. My final kinetic energy is 1/2 times how much mass is moving. That's 3.5 kilograms. And multiplied by the final speed, 1.714 meters per second squared. And out of that, I get 5.14 joules of energy, which means 3.86 joules of energy is not in the motion of the masses, but is instead stored in the compression of the spring. Now I go to my spring energy formula. Potential energy in a spring is 1/2 kx squared. I know the potential energy in there is 3.86 joules. I've got a spring constant of 500 newtons per meter. All that's left is that compression that I'm after. And I do a little bit of work in my calculator, and I get 0.124 meters, or 12.4 centimeters of compression. So I've always liked this problem because it allows us to get into some of the details of what's actually going on during one of these springy collisions.